Now let us discuss some of the applications of lasers. One important application is holography. Holo means complete and graphy means recording. So it is complete recording of the image of the object. In normal photography, we record only two-dimensional image. Only the intensity of light waves which are reflected from the object is recorded. But in holography, we get three-dimensional image. So it is 3D imaging technique. Here we will record intensity and phase of the light waves which are reflected from the object. So intensity and phase both are recorded. So it is complete recording. This technique was found by Dennis Geber and he was awarded a Nobel Prize for this in 1971 for this invention. Now let us see how this complete image is recorded. So for this, a broad laser beam is divided into two parts. One part is called as reference beam. This reference beam is made incident on the mirror from where it is reflected and collected on the photographic plate. So we can see this reference beam is reaching the photographic plate directly after reflection from the mirror. The other part is called as the object beam. This object beam is allowed to fall on the object whose image is to be recorded. Waves in this object beam are reflected from different parts of this object and after reflection they are collected at the photographic plate. This waves in object beam and waves in reference beam interfere with each other and that interference pattern is actually recorded on this photographic plate. So this is how a hologram is formed. A hologram does not contain distinct image of the object. It is only a record of interference pattern formed by the superposition of coherent light beams. One coming from the mirror and the other coming from the object. This interference pattern on the hologram consists of a complex pattern of alternatively placed dark and bright regions, fringes. This hologram is also called as a Geber zone plate, in the honor of Dennis Geber who invented this technique. So this is how hologram is constructed. Now why do we need laser beam? Why it can't be done with the ordinary light? Because we are recording a phase of the light wave, we need the light waves to be in phase and that will be possible only with laser beam. Because in laser beam, light waves are coherent. In ordinary light, light waves will not be coherent, will not be in phase and therefore they cannot be used to record the phase difference. So that is why for holography, laser beam is required. Once the hologram is recorded, we want to see the three-dimensional image from it. We have seen that hologram does not contain a distinct image of the object. It is just a interference pattern in the form of dark and bright fringes. This hologram can be used as a diffraction grating in order to view the three-dimensional image. A laser beam which is identical to the reference beam used at the time of constructing the image is made incident on this hologram and a diffraction pattern is obtained. In some direction we will get maximum as the secondary waves will interfere constructively. In some direction we will get minimum as the secondary waves from hologram will interfere destructively. In order to see the three-dimensional image, the observer can see in the direction along which the maximum is obtained. By tilting his head slightly, the details of the object can be seen. So this is how a three-dimensional image can be seen by using the hologram as a diffraction grating. So this is how the hologram is a two-stage process. In the first stage, the hologram is recorded in the form of interference pattern and in the second stage, the hologram is used as a diffraction grating and a three-dimensional image of the object can be constructed.
Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.